200, 300%, I don't care. But it's been estimated that we have 20 million illegals in this country, and for everyone you have, it's costing the American taxpayer anywhere between $40,000 and $50,000 per year to support them. Instead of calling them undocumented Obama supporters, why don't you call them illegal, like they are? It's an illegal invasion of the country, which illegal invasion is an act of war. Why do they go out of their way to feed them? No. When we should be, you know, cracking down.
Yeah, I agree.
If you get all of them out of the country, that would open up how many millions of jobs to someone who would pay taxes. So right now, they're not paying any, but yet, every year, they get the big refund for the earned income credit.
Okay.
And it's not right.
I, just so you know, I co-sponsored several pieces of legislation to try to rein in the problem with the illegal immigration. I think we're all for legal immigration. You and I, all our relatives, we try to keep it, but we need to fix the illegal immigration, and it's a huge problem. So
I
we're going to do everything.
He passed that one bill to pay parents down 20 million.
No, we can't do that. We can't do that.
We have time for about three more questions.
Where do you have to be?
My name is Nicole McCann. I'm here in Warrensburg, and I work with Sprint. And the reason I'm here today is just expressing my concerns regarding the proposed case that the AT&T is going to take over. Verizon has approximately 94,000 subscribers, and if this transaction goes through, they would control 80% of the revenues that are out there for the mobile industry. When you compare that to other industries that are out there, the oil business, the top two are only 18%. Airlines are only 36%. Baking's 27%. Auto is 37%. But if this is passed, it would be 80% of our industry, which would put approximately 200 employees out of this hospital out of work. So when we talk about jobs and we talk about the concerns that we have with the economy, I'm just asking you to take into consideration that we support declining this with the Department of Justice, the SEC. You know, these are the organizations that will make that decision. But you urging them to move away from that takeover would help us.
We'd be happy to look and see what we can do. It is not something that we vote on per se. It's an agency making that decision. But I'll be happy to look and see what we can do.
Thank you, Congressman Hartzler. Could you repeat what she said? We couldn't hear.
Oh, okay, sure. She works for Sprint and is concerned about, right now there's a merger being talked about between AT&T and T-Mobile, and that she's concerned that what it would do to jobs and stuff, it would disproportionately put out a competition for Verizon and others. So, anyway, she's asking me to do see if there's something I can do, even though it's not something I vote on per se. It's an agency. Anyway, see if there's a program, but it's not a bill per se where it says we're going to spend XYZ as the United States government to try to create jobs. Because that just doesn't work.
Let me stimulus lines came into this state, were sucked up by this state and this county. What was that for the job stimulus?
But as I say, it didn't work, and now we're further into that, almost $1 trillion in debt further.
You still suck that money up to pay their bills. That money never paid those people.
No, but
I'm in construction for around 25-30% unemployed, and there's nothing helping us. There's nothing going, there's nothing coming at us. By you stopping, by you going at OSHA, by you going at all these PLAs, by you going at all of the regulations on powerhouses. You talk about clean air. There's two or three powerhouses, maybe four in this state, that are clean. That's IPAM, the new one, which created thousands of jobs. All the regulations say that they're going to clean your coal up by 2015.
This isn't a forum on Republicans versus Democrats. You can go to a Democratic Party meeting or a Republican Party meeting if you want to talk about that. This is, we're talking about Americans here. We're all Americans. I represent everyone, Democrats, Republicans. I'm honored to do that. And we're trying to do what's best for America. I want to try to get more jobs.